In software engineering, we are taking chapter number 4. We are following the book Software Engineering from Pressman and Maximum. This is process models. Prescriptive process models. So this is a kind of software methodology. The model you have to choose or the process you have to adopt to develop the software. What does prescriptive means? When you go to the doctor, he will give you some prescription. That is, this is the medicine you have to take. These are the things you have to do to get early recovery. So the prescriptive process model, this is all about software development. So this will tell you what will be the structure and what will be the order you have to follow for software development. There are multiple process models we are going to discuss in this prescriptive process model. Again, we are calling it as prescriptive because it is prescribing you what you have to do. It will tell you the set of process elements. Let me give an example. A doctor will tell you that you have to take pantoprazole and domperidone before your breakfast, 1 hour before your breakfast, if you are having trouble of say acidity. But if you take it afterwards, it will not be of much use. So this is the order, structure and all the process elements which is being prescripted to you, right? That is, what are the framework activities, what are the actions, tasks, what will be the work product, what will be the quality assurance you have to follow, adopt, how are you going to control the change. So these are for different projects, small or bigger. So these are the prescription which the model will give. Okay. Now, each process model, it will also tell you which or model you choose. How will be the flow of process? Process is all about the work, what you are going to do. That is the, you know, bigger chunk of work. For example, we learned about the linear process model. Because framework activity is all about the communication, planning, modeling, construction and deployment. So these were 5 major framework activity. And I also told you activity, framework activity have action, they have task set. But the flow of these activity, framework activity, this model, every model will also tell you what will be the workflow. Okay. It can be linear, it can be iterative, it can be evolutionary, even it can be parallel process flow, right? So these flow, these activities, what is the flow? So let me tell you again, a prescriptive process model is all about defining a prescribed set, an ordered set, an indicated set of process elements and a predictable, predictable means you know what kind of workflow you are going to follow in which model, which is better, which is not. The waterfall model. This is also called as classic model, the basic model, the oldest model, the earliest model. Waterfall is all about water coming from or, you know, dropping from a height. I'll tell you about this waterfall, but before that, you need to understand that this waterfall model is prescribed only when the requirements for this problem are clearly understood. You know the requirement. For example, you are a developer, there is a consumer or a user. Now the stakeholder or the user has told you these are the requirements and you have totally understood it. So this is a linear, the workflow will be linear, straight means there will be no circle, no circuit. So let me tell you again, water is always falling due to gravity from top to bottom. It will never go or never go from bottom to top. This will never happen. So similarly, the waterfall model is saying that you have to start with the communication, then planning, then modeling, construction, deployment in a linear fashion from top to down. Let us take an example. Say you already have a software and you are aware that or the that the change or the adaptation, enhancement, emancipation, whatever you have to do, everything you know, and the software is also ready. For example, the government says now the tax was 2%, now we are increasing it to 4%. So you are well aware of the situation, we are well aware. So the well-defined adaptation and enhancement for the existing system, you will use the waterfall model. If you are talking about a software from the scratch, that is the new development effort, you can only use waterfall model when the requirements are clear, clear-cut, well-defined, stable, you and the user or the stakeholder have agreed upon, and there is nothing more to tell. So from communication, the first phase of waterfall model, planning, then modeling, construction and deployment. This is one by one, and this is a proper flow, linear flow, always a linear flow. You can never go back. That is, you always have to go forward. You cannot return back. So the waterfall model, which is, you can imitate it using a waterfall. This is the oldest paradigm of software engineering. That is why we also call it as a classic life cycle model. Classic life cycle model. So this model is suggesting a very systematic means you know it already, right? You have to start from communication till deployment. There is no circuit, as I indicated, there is no circle, there is no repetition. It's systematic, it is sequential, and this will only be done when the requirements are clear, right from the planning to modeling to construction to deployment and even maintenance. Once you give the software, you have to maintain it. So this is the whole process. But there are certain problems with the waterfall model. What are the problems? See, real projects, realistic project, today's world project, fast paced project, they rarely follow the sequential flow which the waterfall model is suggesting. Because if you are at design, some requirement has come. In waterfall model, you cannot go back. Right? Because these requirements are ever changing. A customer who has come to you, or the stakeholders who have come to you for a website, for an app or software, they are not aware of all the requirement. They cannot tell you. No one can tell a requirement in the beginning. Even if you go to the market to take 10 stuff, it is highly likely if you don't write it down, 9 you will be back with 9, 1 you will leave. So requirements cannot be upheld, can be told. And the other problem is, only after construction the actual working version is available. Software is only available when all the sequential systematic flow has taken place. But if there is a problem in between, that is some design issue, some modeling problem, that will be only surfaced when you have already completed the model and you are now at the deployment state. So if the problem or the error is left undetected in between, it will be a disaster. The linear nature, because it is very sequential, very linear, of this classic life cycle model, which we are also calling it as waterfall model, this will lead to a blocking state. That is, if the communications team is preparing SRS, the modeling team and the coding team, what will they do? They are in the blocking state. They may work on some other project, but this project, they are blocked. So the project team members or the software development people, they have to wait for other members to complete their dependent tasks. As I indicated you, the software or the application or the website today is fast paced. The life has changed. The changes will come. So the feature, function, information, they are going to change every time. So for that, the waterfall model may not be that much useful. But if you know the requirement, it's always good to use the basic model, which is the oldest tested waterfall model. The V model. So for V model, if you understand the waterfall model, it's just that. This is just a slight variation of waterfall model. As you know, waterfall model is a systematic planned way of software development when we know the requirements. V model is waterfall model plus the quality. So quality added to waterfall model will make a V model. So variation of waterfall model is the V model. So V model is just a slight variation where the quality has been added. So here V model, it is depicting, it is indicating, representing the relationship of the quality issues, quality assurance action, which are associated with the different framework activity right from the communication to modeling to till the deployment or before the deployment, that is the construction activity. So V model is adding quality with every aspect or each phases of a waterfall model. I hope you got the idea. Waterfall model plus quality is V model. How do we do this? See, the way it is shown or represented, the V, the letter of English alphabets, V represented. So if I'm taking it as a left and this has a right, this is how V is made. So as a software team will go down or move down to the left side of the V, first of all, the problem will be understood, the requirement will be refined, and then the different aspect or technical representation will be done of the problem for the solution, that is requirement modeling, then the architectural design will be done, modeling you can say. Then you are making the component design, and finally once this is being made, you know the design now, you can just code it. Okay, so this is while you are coming down. Once the code is being generated, now we go up on the right hand side of V. Okay, code generation is okay. Now we move up. Now the software team will move up on the other part of V, the right side of V. And here we are going to perform a various series of tests. And this test is basically the quality assurance. For example, we can have a unit testing, integration testing, system testing, and acceptance testing. For code generation, you can do unit testing, and for component design also you can do unit testing. For architecture and component design, you can do the integration testing. For requirement modeling or architectural design, you can do the system testing. And finally, the requirement modeling or whatever requirement is there on the basis of SRS, you can do the acceptance testing. So while you're coming down, you're making the software. While you're going up, you are checking the software. So this is all about verification and validation. So V model is a visual way you can understand how verification and validation will be applied, or these actions will be applied to all the engineering work, software engineering work, coding work, development work, which has been done earlier. Okay. So the quality with waterfall model is V model. There are different testing, even the technical reviews can be done. So V model is all about representation and illustration of how verification and validation actions will be performed or associated with the different phases of engineering action you have taken to build a software. So you see a picture here. Parts are being added, or you can say incrementally this product is being made. So this is an example of what we are going to talk, incremental process model. Incremental means you are always adding certain functions and feature to the previously made. There are certain situations where the software requirement, the user requirement are quite clear. They are well defined, they are stable, there is no change. Everything is clear. So people will ask, why are you not using the waterfall model? You can use the waterfall model because the requirements are clear. But the problem is the development process or the requirement of the user, it is preventing the linear process, which is the waterfall model kind of use of that process model. That is, right from the communication till deployment, you cannot have a linear way because they want something quickly. They will say, okay, just give us some limited features and function, but we want to see the function, software functionality we want to see very quickly. You may refine it for the later releases. But for now, we want this software as early as possible. Okay. What all other things incremental process models have? The incremental model, it is actually a combination of, or it is combining the element of linear and parallel process flows. I hope you remember when we talked about the linear and parallel process flow. Linear is all about, you know, we can say waterfall model. Parallel is when you can framework activity, take framework activity and do it in parallel. So we are combining this A with the D, the linear process flow with the parallel process flow. This is the incremental model concept. So each linear sequence, right from the communication till the code generation or construction, you are delivering the software and then you are incrementing it. Again, you are following the linear sequence. So the process flow for any increment, this can also be incorporated with the prototyping paradigm. I'm not talking about prototyping paradigm. This is also a process model, but this is an evolutionary type of process model that we'll discuss later. But prototype is all about giving the user the basic functionality so that they have a feel that, okay, this is the software we're going to make. But in incremental model, the first product will be a core product. In prototype, it will be a throwaway. But in the incremental, it will be the core product. Now you will give it to the user. Once you give this first increment to the user, user is going to evaluate. It goes on multiple evaluation. And then you will plan, and the user will plan that, okay, what we are going to give in the next increment, because we need to fulfill the customer need. And this process will be repeated again and again, because you are delivering each in the increment. Once the complete product with all the functionality, all the features, all the requirements have been made. Okay. So this increment is done multiple times following the sequence rule. I'll give an example of word processing software. Now, if you are giving someone the project of making a word processing software and he is going to follow, the company is going to follow the incremental process model, the core has to be there in the first increment. So these are the multiple increment you can talk about. Maybe in the first increment, you can get the basic file management, the editing facility, the document production functions. This can be given in the first increment. Then you can also give some, you know, added version like PDF so that the user can check whether they want it or not. Then in the second, you can give more editing and document production capabilities. This you can give for the second one. So first increment, user, you have given user, you get the feedback, they evaluate, then you take those feedback, and then you add more increment, and finally you can give spelling, grammar checking. You have seen when you press shift F7 in Microsoft Word, you get a thesaurus, spell check. All these are advanced page layout capability. So this can be given in the fourth increment. So these are the multiple increment I'm talking about. This is the incremental process model where we apply, or where we combine the linear and the parallel, and every increment will have something for the user. So the incremental model, it will deliver, means the incremental model will deliver releases, and these releases are version 1, version 2, version 3. We also are calling it as an increment, and that will add the functionality. For example, 50 functionalities were there. You first you give 20 and you get some feedback. You can delete some of them, add more of them. So 20, 20, 20, 10, like this, you can give the customer different releases in increments. Evolutionary process models. So we will be talking about the prototype, the spiral, very important one. But this we are going to take in the next discussion. Till then, thank you so much. Take care of yourself.